Patty?
I wasn't as sharp as I used to be.
I don't know, Wendy. I hope I'm doing this right. I have no clue. Okay, Patty. I understand we're wishing you a happy 70th birthday. I couldn't be happier to be here to help to wish you that. I have so many fond memories of you, the most being when you were a little girl. I was 13 when you were born. So by the time I was 15, I was in high school, and you were running down Greenbush Road to jump in my arms when I came to visit you whenever I could. I'm here today with my nice, with my nice, new perm. I get them when I have to go to the nursing homes. So anyways, I just thought I'd give you a little chuckle on my perm. When you were a little girl, and I would come on the bus to visit you at Greenbush Road, you were 2, 3, 4 maybe years old, and you had 2 little ponytails on the side, and you would run with your little legs down the hill to meet Auntie Izzy. You were the first granddaughter, the first niece, the first baby in the family for a long time. We all adored you. Even Grandpa Gundeman would go down to check to see how you are and to see how Mommy was doing. Sorry, my hand keeps getting in the way. Probably should have prepared better for this, but it's me. What are you going to do? I remember the day when you were a little baby and we were all gathered at Mrs. Roy's house. You and Richie were getting ready to move down south because he was in the service and you were going to make your home down there. Nobody wanted you to go or the baby. They didn't care about Richie. He could go, but everyone wanted you to stay. But Richie was adamant, and so were you, and so off you went. Of course, we missed you when you were gone, but you have come a long way. I know you're missing Richie, and so do we all, and feel bad that you're alone. But you have a wonderful family, and they all love you, especially Auntie Izzy. So I'm going to say to you a happy 70th birthday. I have some notes over here. A happy birthday. And I wish you, may God bless you and guide you, Patty. I love you, and I wish you a full life of love and happiness and very happy 70th birthday. Okay, now Uncle Bobby's going to say happy birthday because with me, he has to come. So wait a minute. Here he comes. You didn't? So here's what's happening. He was supposed to put a shirt on. And I just turned around, and he hadn't done it, so he's running to get a shirt. Isn't it always true? Auntie Izzy's always yelling, oh, for God's sakes, Uncle Bobby. Bobby Vrusho. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Bobby Vrusho. So here he comes to wish you a happy birthday. Well, I thought he was coming, but he's still in the closet. So this video is going on and on. Sorry, Wendy. This is what you told me to do. I hope it's right. Not the shirt I would have picked, but here we go. Just put your face in there. There.
Patty, all the best on your 70th. You're a super kid. Glad I got to know you. You know? I've actually adopted all of Izzy's family because you're all great people. Keep up the good work. I know it's a lot of work over where you are now, but you're one hell of a daughter. And again, happy, happy 70th. God bless.
Bye, Pumpkin. I love you. See you next week.
Happy birthday to my niece, Patricia. I am so happy to be a part of this, Patricia, and I'm wishing you the best of days. And there's only one word to sum it up. Favorite. Unc loves you.
Happy birthday, Patty.
May you have many, many more. This is from your sister-in-law and brother-in-law. I was in your wedding. Remember that?
Have a good day.
Have a nice day.
Bye.
I am so happy to have an opportunity to be able to be part of this tribute. And I'm able to be here because of the likes of your children that you brought up. And they have dealt patiently with me, who was completely oblivious to the use of technology. And Renee's sitting here right next to me.
Hi, Mom.
She came down to help me. To help me be able to get on and record this video. So that I'm deeply grateful. Good job bringing up such good children. The things that I remember most are, first of all, how well you and my brother got along with one another. Incredibly well. You just had such a deep respect for one another. You cared for one another. You were looking out for one another all the time. And you were blessed to have that opportunity to be together. And you were together for such a long time, all the way through high school. From the beginning of the marriage, it was Thanksgiving, always Thanksgiving, the most complicated meal of the year. And we had it in the varieties of places that you lived, some small, some across the hall from one another, but mostly there at Wyola. And the remembrance of your coming to Wyola and building the house there and working together to cooperate in providing a home there at the top of the hill for your family and your children. And it was a joy to have all of you so close to us there at Wyola. I remember particularly, as I was thinking this over, the day before Mommy died, I got up to the hospital pretty early. But who did I find there ahead of me? You were there, Patty. I said, Patty, what are you doing here? And she said, I had to come by one more time and say thank you. Thank you for raising such a wonderful son. And thank you also for being the one who gave me so much encouragement when I was pregnant with Matthew. You know, there was the same amount of years between Richard and Paul as between Renee and Matthew. And many people said they were feeling sorry for me. But your mother said, your mother-in-law said, this one is God's gift to you, Patty. This one you will appreciate so very much. And I had to come up one more time and thank her for that. And there were so many other instances of especially there at Wyola and times that we had. But the wonderful, tender, loving, devoted care that you gave to my brother, your husband, in the last difficult days of his life. That was pretty special. And that was a huge challenge. And boy, you stepped up to the plate and you accepted it. And you were not this martyr doing it alone. You organized the rest of us to help give you a hand in that incredible journey. And so for that, I'm deeply grateful. And I had the greatest admiration for you. And my love for you has only grown over the years. And I was distraught that I was not going to be a part of this tribute. And through the help of Renee, I'm here and tell you that I love you. And I have the greatest admiration and affection for you. Well done. God bless you.
Morning, Patty. Calling from sunny Florida. Another beautiful 80-degree day. A little windy today, though, but beautiful. I want to say happy birthday. This is a great thing Wendy did, is doing for you. The only bad thing about you being 70 is I'm going to be 69. So on a serious note, we're so happy that you're going to have a great birthday. Wish we were there to share it with you. We'll see you at the end of the month. You've been a great, great sister, incredible friend, obviously an incredible mother, wife. You're the best, Patty. Always have been. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Patty. Best sister-in-law. Okay, best 70-year-old sister-in-law. Happy birthday. We love you.
Have a great day, Patty. Bye.
Happy birthday, Patty. We didn't have to think twice about where to film this. Here we are in our kitchen.
And we can't wait for you to join us.
We hope you have a wonderful birthday. We love you.
Love you.
You do my... Hey, Pat. Okay. So I just recorded half of this tribute and my phone wasn't on. Okay. So I am not the tech savvy one, but today is your birthday. Happy birthday. 70 years old is quite an accomplishment. I just can't even imagine that you are 70 and that I am not that far behind you, and our other siblings range from the late 50s through the 60s, and now you are hitting 70. Who would have thought? You, in the 70 years since you have been here on this earth, okay, you have had many roles. A preppy teenager who got her picture and article in the newspaper. You dressed so snazzy that day, and that style has come back. From the little girl with the curly hair that everybody just loved, you were the first granddaughter, and just everybody just thought you were the be it and end it of all. From what I understand, you are still Uncle Sal's favorite, which is fine. That doesn't matter to me. You're my favorite, too. So we'll let that one pass. Let me see. You got married. I was much younger. And we didn't start our adult relationship until I got my license and was able to come out and visit you in Oxford. So I think that was the start of a beautiful relationship we have. We've had ups and downs and sideways and upside down, and that's okay. That's what relationships are about. So a tribute to you who've raised four great kids, who have several grandchildren, and the title G-Ma, which is pretty great in itself. You are an inspiration, not only to your kids, but to so many others, Patty, me included. Your engineering mind always floors me because we can accomplish anything. Moving furniture, whether it's in your house or my house, great job, because that's the engineering you put behind it. I constantly will brag about you because you can take things apart and put them back together. Dining room tables, you can invent things so people can't break in your windows or doors. I mean, there you go. You should patent half of this stuff. But on today, when you turn 70, you have a life filled with so many exciting things, so many places you've been and things you've seen, things you've done, whether it's by yourself, whether it's with friends, whether it was with Richie or your kids or your sisters and brothers. They are memories, and they should be good memories for you. And I hope they are good memories for you. Patty, I love you. I know I've said it to you before, and I don't take it for granted that you are always there, whether it's for me, whether it's for Mom, whether it was for Richie or Daddy or any of your kids or your grandkids. You are a solid, positive influence on all of us. And happy birthday. I hope you have a great, great day, Patty. Bye.
Hey, Patty. It's Mary Pat. Just reaching out to wish you a very happy 70th birthday. I was quite pleased when Wendy sent me a text and asked me if I could share one of my favorite memories with you. And I had a hard time coming down with just one memory, since I have so many fond memories of our years up there on Delawanda and Wyola at the Roy compound. But this one I'm sharing with you, I've also shared with many people because it brought a smile to my face. I don't know if you remember, but usually on Sundays, we would have dinner at my mom and dad's house, and I would never, ever go back home without stopping over and visiting with you and Richie before I said my final goodbye. And there was one time that David had come with me, and I just walked in like I did 99.9% of the time. And he said to me, "Aren't you going to ring the bell and knock on the door?" I said, "No, David, that's just for company." I said, "I'm not company, I'm family." But what was even funnier is when we walked in the house, it came up that I didn't ring the doorbell. And you said to him the exact same thing. "Mary Pat never rings. She's family. She just walks in." So on that note, Patty, thank you for all these years of including me and making me and my family feel a part of your family. Again, happy 70th, and I wish you many more years of health and happiness.
Hello, Patty Roy. Happy birthday. So your kids, Wendy Ann, wants everyone to do a tribute to you. So what can I say about Patty Roy that probably everyone already hasn't said? So you're an inspiration. You're a hero. Small in nature. Huge in personality. Things that you've taught us is to always try to find the positive, which is something that I try and live my life by lately. Not necessarily in the past, but certainly lately. And I'm grateful to you for that. Please keep on being you. 70 years old. Holy cannoli. Do you realize that's 10 times 7? Ugh. 35 times 2? 70. Wow. You look good for 70, Pat. Really good. Happy birthday, sister. I love you. Stay you.
Hey, Patty. Happy birthday. 70 years. It's amazing. Fantastic. And so the question was asked, what is your favorite memory with Patricia Roy? And it's like, it's an impossible question to answer. 53 years of memories. Yeah, who can begin? I have so many. But I think probably one of my favorite ones is actually one of my first ones. I forget what year it was, but Dad and I went down to Logan Airport to pick up Uncle Mike. Sorry, Mike, I'm bringing up this story again. And we were down there all day. And there was an enormous blizzard in Massachusetts. And I was pretty young. I had to be about maybe 10 years old, 10, 11 years old. And, just a long story short, Dad and I never got Uncle Mike. We were there for like 7 hours. We got home. We drove down the Mass Pike, this raging blizzard. We get to the house, and Mom and Richard were awake waiting for us, probably about 11, 12 o'clock at night. And they said, "Shh, shh, be quiet. Patty's sleeping in the other room." And it was like, "Patty's here?" It's like, that's amazing. Because I think it was like the first woman that ever slept in the house that wasn't my mother. And I was just so excited. I don't even know why I was so excited. But I think I was excited because I kind of had a feeling I was going to know you for at least another 53 years, which is now. And I was so happy, and I almost couldn't go to sleep that night, just knowing that you were there, and I wanted to wake up in the morning and see you. So that's one of my earliest and favorites. There are so many other favorites. I mean, they're, you know, countless Thanksgivings are fantastic. Working up on Fairmont Ave is memorable, and I enjoyed it. Oxford, working at Oxford, building the addition at Oxford, and just so many. There's a few sad ones too. The night we lost my brother, your husband, Richie, that was a sad one. And losing Dad, losing Mom. But one thing that just kept running through my mind, and I'm late on doing this because who can remember everything? And I didn't even know what I was going to say and how do I say it all. And I just realized it's impossible to say it all. But one of the things that kept running through my mind was the constant. You know, our constant, see, in our time together, in our family, you being my sister, not having a sister prior to you, and how much I love you. So, happy birthday. Can't wait to do your 80th tribute. And I hope this is my first and only take. I hope it was a good one. And I'll talk to you soon. Love you. Bye.
Happy birthday, Patty. Aunt Patty. Love you. Have a special day.
Happy birthday, Patty. Best of health for many more years to come, young lady. Have a great day.
Happy birthday, Patty. Patty.
Auntie Patty. Cousin Patty. What's your name? Auntie Patty. Happy birthday. Love you.
Hi, Patty. Happy birthday. First of all, I love you. My favorite memory would be when you came home from Alabama and you were waiting for us at the end of our driveway and we were walking down the street and we all saw each other. And we all just hugged. I forget for how long, but we just hugged and then we got to play with little Richie. So, again, I love you and I hope you have the best birthday of all. Bye.
Okay. Hi, Mom. Happy birthday. This is your video for your tribute surprise.
Birthday tribute. Happy birthday.
It was difficult coming up with a specific memory that I could remember. The biggest thing that I think that sticks in my mind about you growing up, actually up until even now, is just your busyness and you bustling around the kitchen constantly. It has been difficult to try to relieve you of some of those duties. But I seem to remember always food being around, making meals, always dinner on the table. Some of the best school lunches that anybody had. Yeah. That's what I remember.
I'd say probably one of my memories is the trip to the Cape that I was able to go on. You know, as kids, we could just go and enjoy it. But now as an adult, you realize all the hard work that's put into that and all the food preparation you did, all the planning, all the everything that you put together. It was really great. Thank you.
Well, I hope you have a wonderful birthday. I guess today we're going to not let you be a bustling kitchen person today. Yeah, we're going to take care of all that.
None of that today.
Well, happy One birthday, day. Mom.
Happy birthday.
You ever put the camera on yourself and you think, wow, is that what people really see? It's like, my head is gigantic. My nose is huge. Anyways, happy birthday. Here's to 70 years, and we're supposed to share our favorite memory. And for me, mine's going to be a culmination of memories. Over the years, you've always made me feel like I was not just, God, you know, dating back to when I was 16 years old. You made me feel like I was a part of your family, and not just Wendy's boyfriend, not just Wendy's husband, but one of your sons. And I wanted to say thank you for all the emotional support, words of wisdom. Even though when you don't want some, you would get some. But your financial support, I, you know, struggled financially going through college, and you guys helped me out. And other memories that pop into my head, I want to say, I think our trip to Gettysburg is probably going to top most people's lists. That was really fun. I had a great time. Again, happy birthday. Here's to 70 years. We'll talk to you later.
Happy birthday, Mom. I wanted to share a favorite memory with you on your birthday. And it was when we were younger and it was snowing outside and we were having a family game night inside. And I think it was dark and we got all bundled up and got our really big toboggan sled and went in the backyard to go sledding as a whole family. And I just remember it being special because you kind of broke out of serious mom mode and we were all laughing and having fun in the backyard. I think we then came in and you made like fresh, real hot cocoa for everyone. So I've tried to do that with my own kids, tried to not always be serious mom all the time and show them that we can have fun too. Happy birthday, Mom. Love you.
Hi, Mom. Happy birthday. Gonna share a couple fun memories that I have. Beach, Cape. The weeks we would go down there and we would spend the day on the beach and have lunch on the beach and happy hour, taking walks to Rexall's for new comic books. That was always a real treat. That was a really great, fun childhood memory. Also, Monday night dinners after I moved out. It was a weekly thing for a long time. The best meal I had all week, most likely, especially in my single days when I didn't really cook at all. Radio City Music Hall and the Rockette Show, that was a real treat, probably something I'm never going to get to do again. It was really a once-in-a-lifetime thing, and I was glad I got to share that with you and Wendy. And finally, my wedding. Going shopping for a wedding dress with you and having you all to myself that day and having you and Dad walk me down the aisle. You guys were always a team, and that day wasn't going to be any different. And it was really something I hold near and dear to my heart. So very happy birthday. Here's to many more. And I love you. Bye.
Hi, Mom. I have a favorite memory of you that it goes back to, I think, my 17th or 16th birthday. And it was a rock concert that you and Dad didn't want me and John Paul to go to. So John Paul and I rode our bikes down to the auditorium that day and kind of parked outside to see if we could get into the concert. And so, you know, things went along and we ended up going to the concert. And well, my memory is when you picked us up and drove us home, I thought you were going to be really mad at us, but you were like really excited and wanted to know how the concert went and were just really cool about picking us up after the concert. And it was, that's my favorite memory because that was my favorite time of my life. I mean, when I was a teenager going to my first concerts and stuff, and you were happy to see me go. So thank you for that. I love you very much and I hope you have a happy birthday.
Happy 70th birthday, Mom. We just wanted to take a moment and let you know how much you are valued and appreciated in our families. We appreciate all that you do for us. You go above and beyond, and not everybody does that. You're an extraordinary person, and we love you so much. We hope you have a great day and many more. Happy birthday.
Hello, Grandma. Happy birthday. My favorite memory with you is taking a sibling group on Christmas Eve a couple years ago. I had a good time.
Happy birthday, Ma. One of my good memories is when you and Richie came up and check out our place up north and hang out with us for a little while. I hope you enjoy your day.
Happy birthday, Grandma. My memory with you is when me, you, and Nay went to the TD Garden to watch Colin win his playoff game. And I hope you have a happy birthday.
Happy 70th birthday, Grandma. Hopefully 25 treats you really well. Age is always just a number. Definitely been a lot of good memories, basically my whole life with you and Grandpa, but my favorite memory will probably have to be first time I ever went to a Bruins game, first and only time so far. Hopefully you and I can go to TD Garden and catch at least one more. Happy birthday. I love you.
So I'd say probably my favorite memory with Grandma was when she took me up to visit the Cog Railway at Mount Washington. I thought it was really interesting learning about the history of the Cog Railway. The sights of the mountain were beautiful, and I had a lot of fun taking that trip, and I'll always appreciate Grandma for taking me on that trip.
Hey, Grandma. Getting ready for your birthday up here up at St. Anselm, and I'm saying pretty excited. So I was asked to recollect my favorite memory spent with you. And for me, it's got to be our trips into Boston. No matter what we did, I argue we'd had an awesome trip into Boston each time, from the couple of Red Sox games we've been to. I know we've just gone into Boston for the sake of walking around the city and having a lunch. But the best was obviously our trip, our riding in style trip to the Blue Man Group. One of the best times I had with you and my cousins, and you know, I know there's nothing I can do to top your tribute to me for graduation, but riding in style with you, I would do that any day of the week. So here we go. She really wanted one kiss stand to see me walk out the door. God, for mom and dad, for sticking two together, cause we don't know how. Definitely one of the best times, definitely one of the best memories with you, Grandma. So I hope you have a good one. Happy 70th birthday.
Hi, Grandma. Happy birthday. I love you, and I'm really grateful that you're a part of my life, and I wanted to let you know that I love you, and I'm thankful for every single thing you do for our family and for everybody in general.
Hey, Grandma, just want to wish you a happy 70th birthday, and we've had lots of great memories over the years, but one of my favorites is when we got to go to Annie with me, you, Hannah, Auntie, and Mom, and we ended up stuck in the parking lot because Mom left her ticket in her phone, and nothing really seems to go right when we have our trips together, but that's what makes for the good memories, so happy birthday, and I hope we have many more.
Okay. Hi, Dima. It's me, the favorite, obviously, but first of all, happy 70th birthday. It's a big number, big milestone. A wise old lady, lived a lot. Got some years, got some knowledge. I sound like an idiot. Anyways, I think my fondest memory has got to be like those times when you would invite me and Ava over for like sleepovers and you would give us like tons of snacks and hot cocoa if it was like cold out. And me and Ava would always sleep on the couch. And you would always just, it was just so good. We would have, like, good food. And then, like, me and Ava would stay up until, like, ungodly hours of the night with rainbow looms or, like that toy that's, like a block board. And it was, like, a lady, like, as like a picture of a lady. And then you have these little block clothing they just put on her. It was weird. And I loved it. Like, gotta be my favorite memory because I don't know. It was just nice. It was nice to be at your house. I don't know. It was just like a comfortable feeling of like, I like this. I'm really bad at explaining things, but that's my favorite memory with you. I love you, Grandma.
Hello, Grandma. Happy 70th birthday. I love and appreciate absolutely everything you do. I love you. This is a big achievement, and I hope you the best. Have a good day.
Oh, yeah, Mom.
Say, I love you. Give her a kiss. Go.